Well, how'd first one go? Real practice with everybody.
I think it went well. Obviously, being able to go live with everybody here. Obviously, we have some guys out, but for that to be, you know, a first official practice, I think it definitely went well.
How different was it from maybe workouts you guys have had collectively as groups or even smaller groups of teammates?
I mean, I think it's so different because, you know, you actually have all the vets here, you know, all the young guys. Coaches can actually coach. And then when we got out there and did 5-on-5, we actually have referees out here. So, you know, you can play as much pickup basketball as you want. Nothing ever simulates what a game could be like and then what, you know, a real practice could be like. But like I said, I think for the first one, you know, most of the time, that first practice gets really sloppy, but I don't think we had any of that today. So I think it was a good one.
Have you had a moment yet where you look over and you see DeRozan, obviously he's in the Kings uniform, some of the other talent on this team and go, man, it's kind of real.
Yeah, definitely. I mean, one big thing is just adding another guy that's able to get downhill, able to break down the defense, able to get to the free throw line. Like I said, we have real refs out here, so they're calling fouls that you would call in the game. He's getting to the line like he normally does. So just having another guy like that just adds to us. And I think, you know, kind of what we were changing defensively, I think the team looked really good as well.
Were those refs allowing the physicality that you guys were able to play with at the end of last season?
Yeah, a bit. But, like, obviously, you know, hands getting through the lane, you know, they're not calling every single one because you'd be at the line all game. So they definitely let some stuff go. But like I said, he's still able to get downhill. He has the strength. And then when the defense is collapsing, he's able to kick it out to guys.
There are many that consider you like the fastest player in the league. And I know pace has been a major emphasis for Monty McNair and for this group getting back to that pace this year. What's the difference, though, between just raw speed and then offensive pace?
I mean, I think, and it's funny because I always say this, and like I don't just go out there and just start running fast. Playing with paces, playing in different gears, being able to slow down, speed up. Obviously, we want to get the ball up the court fast, but playing fast, you're just running up and down, isn't helping anybody. So playing with pace has meaning to it, and we're not just going out there just to run fast.
DeMar said there was a play where you ran by, and he said it was like a car flying by. what are the keys to you learning to play with him and him learning to play with you and adjusting to the pace?
Yeah, I mean, you continue to try to learn each other's spots. And it comes with talking. I mean, we always talk about communication defensively. It goes hand in hand with offense. You got to be able to talk to each other. Obviously, you know, a lot of our offense is read and react, but you still have to be able to communicate with your mouth. And that makes things a lot easier. And it's funny because we were going through some stuff, and he was, what was this, 5-on-0, no defense out there. So he was like, man, this makes shit, like, easy. And I was like, yeah, and we've talked about it before. I'm like, our offense may look complicated, but once you, like, know what's going on, it becomes really easy to understand. And when he started getting how the offense kind of functioned, he was like, wow, like, I kind of see why, you know, it moves the way it moves. And I think he fits in perfectly.
DeMar said
you've got Keon playing alongside you at least early in camp. What does he do to help you sort of on the defensive end and sort of complete your offense there?
I mean, he shoots the ball extremely well. That's one thing that I feel like people don't give him credit for. I mean, he's a 40% three-point shooter shooting like 4 a game. Like, that's obviously, you know, when you're shooting 7-8, you know, you're an elite shooter, but his percentage is elite. And I mean, what he brings defensively, he's able to pressure the ball. He's able to get deflections if he's not on the ball. He communicates really well. He has great instincts defensively. Like, you don't teach to go under on shooters, but there are times where you have to go under, and he's able to just slide or roll off of a screen and still contest shots, get blocks, get steals. Those are things that you can try to teach someone, but they just might not have the footwork to do those things. And he just came out here, and even his first year, like, you can see that he just knows how to play defense, and he creates that spark for us, especially in the starting lineup right now.
DeMar said Malik was chirping a little bit out there.
Oh, Malik's talking. That's the way that he is. And practice went over a little bit today, so he let the coaches know. So he saw the practice sheet and was like, yeah, we were supposed to be done a while ago. But that's Malik being Malik. So we don't want him to change. You need that. I mean, it keeps everybody accountable, but it also keeps practice a little lighthearted.
What do you see from De'Aaron tomorrow?
I mean, he commands so much attention, especially when he has the ball. And even when he does command that attention, he's able to still get to his spot, still put the ball in the basket. And then when 3-4 guys collapse, you get a lot of open shots. Like, I'm just standing there, and I'm like, usually guys don't – I mean, practice is also a little different. Like, you don't going to practice getting denied how you would in games at times, but just the way that he's able to create for Domas, create for Keegan, create for myself, it makes the game a whole lot easier for everybody.
How do you pick his brain right now? He has so much that there's not a lot of people you pick their brains, but he's somebody.
Yeah, I mean, I think it's a little different. Like, he's going into year 16. I think Vince was going into year 17 or 18 when I got here, and Zeebo was going into like 15 or 16. But I think the difference is he's still playing at an extremely high level. So just being able to watch what he's doing and how he's doing it, and then obviously asking questions, what he sees here and what he sees there. And obviously we're very different players, but there's little bits and pieces that you can take from somebody like that.
Was it strange to not have HB out there?
Definitely, definitely not having him. I mean, he's sat next to me in the locker room for 5.5 years, so I also took his locker, though. but no, I mean, it's definitely a little different. But that's the nature of the NBA. You know, we've had a lot of guys traded or out the league that I've played with in my career. And I mean, the only difference is we were here for a long time together. But it's great that we, you know, had those experiences and still keep in touch. So it's not like, you know, anyone's, you know, dead and gone. So it's the nature of the league. Nature of the league.
Thanks, everyone.
My locker's next. I made Keegan sit next to me.
That was my question. Keegan moved the most.